Call the meeting back to order. Welcome guests in the audience from closed session. We moved by Bev Cutting, seconded by Carol Lawrence. Be it resolved, the county council municipality of West Gray hereby returns to open session of council at
10:06.
Any questions on the motion? All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. Yes. And we will confirm, I guess, only those matters that we went into closed session with were discussed in closed session. Matters coming out of closed session. We did positive performance appraisal was identified by the council for our CAO, so we'll say that coming from closed session. Public meetings, we have none today. And down to the consent agenda. Consent agenda. You have the agenda. Have the agenda in front of you. One item. Oh, we're not over to that just yet. One item I do have here would fall under correspondence. We have an item request to proclaim April the 2nd, 2016 as World Autism Awareness Day and to raise Autism Ontario's flag on April the 4th to proclaim that in the province of Ontario. And that is in there. We didn't know if any... Do we have a motion to confirm that, Kerry, or not?
At the end, I think there's one for...
There is one at the end, okay?
Yeah, look at what in the sheets there.
Oh, very good. Okay, there is.
It's a direct motion if okay. They want to pull it and move it.
Yes, we could do that as a direct motion at the end. If that suits council. We talked about it that time. Autism. Okay. All right. Anything else in the consent agenda? With that one little minor change. Do we have one that's motion to us for the agenda?
That's not consent. This one here is the consent.
Okay.
That's the consent agenda.
All right. Okay, we need that one to be signed. A lot of paperwork going on here. Okay, I do have a resolution to adopt the agenda, though. Moved by Don B. Marshall and seconded by Bev Cutting. Be it resolved that items A1 to C1 inclusive contain Part 1 consent agenda. Be adopted and further that authorization be given for the action to be taken as may be necessary to give effect to the recommendations contained therein. So this is from A1 to C1. Okay, any question on that? Councilor Lawrence.
I would request that the West Gray Public Library Board minutes of December 14th be pulled and deferred to our committee of the whole meeting. And in particular, it's the West Gray Library Facilities Review that I would like brought forward to the
committee. Okay. Everybody see some... Are they nodding? Anybody have a concern with that? All right, so that'll be pulled and brought forward to the next committee of the whole. Anything else? Any council members concerned? All right, we have a resolution concerning the agenda moved and seconded. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. Minus that one item. All right. Now, do we have another one? No, not yet. The other one for D1. D1 to D3. Thought I saw one. No.
Is it still?
Well, that's autism on the switch by itself.
So people would still have a dog.
Okay. Nope. All right. Okay, we'll move down to communications from mayor and council. Does anyone have any communications this morning for council? Counselor Hutchison.
I'd just like to remind the general public that the Frazzle Fest weekend is coming up this weekend, and we have a number of activities planned. Saturday downtown Durham, there's a number of things taking part. You can test some chili from different restaurants, and you can do a little scavenger hunt. And then on Monday is family day, so the activities are at our local recreation facilities. So there's some things going on at the Durham Arena. Also in Eaton, there's free public skating, and in Newstead, we have some roller skating. So big weekend for our area, so hopefully people will come out and take part, and hopefully we get some snow so we can build snow sculptures.
Okay, very good. I think by the sounds of the weather, it is supposed to drop significantly by the weekend, so people might be dancing in the snow to stay warm. Alrighty. Yes. Okay. Sorry, we momentarily lost another motion. Just momentarily. We had the paperwork and it is signed, but we just... it's concerning a motion before this. Moved by Don B. Marshall and second by Rob Thompson. Be resolved that the minutes of the regular meeting of the Council of Municipality of West Gray held on January 18th, 2016. The special committee meeting of Committee of the Whole of the Municipality of West Gray held on January the 6th. The meeting of the Committee of the Whole of the Municipality of West Gray held on January the 25th. And the special meeting of Committee of the Whole of the Municipality of West Gray held on February the 1st be adopted as printed. Further, that the minutes of West Gray Committees A2 be received as circulated. And further, the minutes of other committees A3 be received as circulated. Sorry. Okay. That's the one that Councillor Lawrence was on the other. Okay. So that one was pulled for discussion at Committee of the Whole. Okay. Any questions? All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. Thanks, Carrie, for that. I was remiss to say that, as you can see, the mayor is not here. He is, probably listening to a little Bob Marley music right now as we speak. And Carrie, thank you very much for filling in for the clerk this morning who is ill, so was not able to make it in. But thank you very much, and I'm sure we'll get things done in a suitable manner. Okay. Any other communications from any of the council members? Okay, seeing none. Delegations. This morning we do have one delegation. Stacy Becker from Durham, Newstead, and Normanby Firefighters Association. Welcome, Stacy, this morning. And, yeah, wherever you'd like to present from either there or at the podium, if you'd like.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay. Normanby, yeah, I'll keep yeah, one. Exactly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, punch that on the bottom right hand. There, you're live now, Stacy.
Good to go?
Yep.
Just here to represent all three firefighter associations, Durham, Newstead, and Eaton. We've wrote a letter that I'm going to read to you. On the previous page, you'll see the letter of intention that we sent in October 14th. And not sure if everybody got that or not. So I'm just going to read what I have here for a letter. As of January 20th, the other page. To the attention of West Gray Council, on behalf of the West Gray Firefighters Association, we would like to sincerely thank you for our wage increase of $1 per hour. We fully understand the municipality is currently experiencing some level of financial limitations, but unfortunately we feel that you have neglected to invite our designates to the meeting of the whole, in which decisions were discussed and agreed upon. A letter of intent to meet with council was written and discussed with all association members and submitted in hopes that we could collectively have an opportunity to speak and voice our concerns. It was disheartening, to say the least, that we were unable to negotiate with council regarding the current wages and potential written contract to be put in place similar to surrounding departments. Fortunately, in today's society, access to social media and information has brought us closer to our surrounding municipalities, including our own. It is well known that Elmwood firefighters earn significantly more and that we, the taxpayers of West Gray, pay 52% of those wages paid to the Elmwood Fire Department due to locale borders. So we are left to question, are they considered to be more superior value than West Gray firefighters? The West Gray Firefighters Associations feel all firefighters should be treated equally, especially within our own municipal boundaries. It was a disappointment to hear one of our West Gray counselors state that we have potentially set a bad example of volunteerism to our students and youth. We feel that maybe before stating opinions of that magnitude, some research should be completed regarding any future decisions. We can also assure that 40 hours of volunteering from high school students does not affect their sleep at night because of tragedy and trauma they've witnessed because of the limits of their duties. Trauma of horrific levels that only those who served in the emergency field would ever truly understand. The days of the Bucket Brigade are also well behind us. Providing fire rescue service indisputably requires more training than in the past. If being a volunteer firefighter only consisted of acting to the sound of a town bell for men and women to respond to a fire with buckets in hand, then yes, I suppose we could do it without being compensated for any skill. We are now required to be trained extensively and continually upgraded to modern standard training that equal the quality and skill set of a full-time fire service. This may be an opportune time to inform some council members of the separate entities between associations and departments. It's been brought to our attention that one of our councillors has been making public statements in regards to us being paid while attending community events. This is, of course, untrue. Hours dedicated to direct fire services are logged, monitored, and compensated. Hours served through the association are not. It's through the three West Gray Fire Associations that we volunteer many hours of our personal time to the community with events like parades for children. Again, the hours volunteered through the associations are not logged or paid for. We also volunteer association time raising funds through fundraisers so we can provide our respected stations with additional necessary equipment that in some instances exceed the budget allowance. This past year, we also assisted West Gray in arranging a barbecue for the volunteers of the municipality. We're happy to host this barbecue event on our own volunteered, unlogged association time. These are just a few things to consider when stating such opinions like our departments no longer reflect that of a volunteer. In the past 20 years, the Durham Fire Association alone has raised roughly $160,000 in funds. We do not have a number as of yet to account what Ayton and Newstead has contributed to the West Gray, since the amalgamation. However, the above numbers should provide a clear idea of what we do beyond our department duties. Other community events like hockey game fundraisers, Christmas in the country, parades, golf tournaments, dances, etc., are included in what the association organizes. While most don't understand or recognize the two separate entities, we always pride ourselves in combining both the association and department roles as one unit as a whole. Money raised by our association also filter directly back into our communities through outgoing donations, etc. In addition to purchasing equipment unable to be funded by West Gray. The previous initial letter to council was to request the opportunity to discuss equal wages for the fire department services, not the firefighter association time that we volunteer. We ask that you please understand the differences of the two. In closing, we apologize in advance for any comments that may have been taken out of context. We only request respectful ground when in discussion amongst the councillors. The fire chief of West Gray had no part in this letter, nor is he aware of such a letter. With kind regards, Ayton, Durham, and Newstead Firefighter Associations. Thank you.
Okay, Stacy, thank you. That, would you entertain any questions if anybody has any questions for you? Not sure if, but if you
sure.
If you have that opportunity, that'd be great. Questions for Stacy? Councillor Hutchins, go ahead, Doug.
Yes, Doug.
Just, you can just, maybe we've seen this, but I don't, you can refresh my memory. What is the difference in salary or wages for Durham Newstead versus Elmwood?
As of now, we make, with $1 raise, a captain, $24 an hour. They make $25 for all firefighters, plus the captains, officers all get honorariums, which we do not. So at the end of it all, they do make significantly more.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else? All right. I'm seeing none. Okay. I don't have any myself. Thanks, Stacy,
for right,
bringing
you.
This to our attention. Councillor Lawrence.
I just want and hope that you understand that that's certainly not all of council's feelings in relation to your volunteerism. The most of us understand.
I understand.
Okay, thanks for that explanation. Going forward, obviously we want to continue to work with your association. That's a given. We can understand your concerns. I think they've been noted here. There won't be any, shall we say, quick resolution to this, obviously, but going forward, okay. And if I could ask one question, that's probably a long line of the last line, I guess, about the fire chief had no part in this letter. Is he aware of such a letter? I guess you chose to make him aware of the letter because
Okay.
Just wanted to clarify that for everybody. Okay.
Yep.
Thanks for that, Stacy.
All right.
Very good. Okay. If there's no more questions, any business arising from the previous meeting? Seeing none here. We'll move into staff reports, and first, filling in and doing other duties is our Director of Finance Treasurer. Carrie, do you want to start that right from here? I've got to find that first of all.
Up there.
Right there, yep. Okay. Director of Finance, Carrie, ahead, and of course we have the vouchers, is up first. And we need, everybody's had the vouchers in front of them. Any questions about any of the votes? Sir Hutchison.
On page 7 of the Carrie's report, I guess, or page 81 in our on our agenda. I just have to refer to that now. 81. Just a question about the street light costs. I guess it's street light repairs, and I'm just wondering, and maybe I'm not sure if anyone can answer this or whether it needs to be Ken, but it just seems like we're paying a lot for street light repairs, and I know that we're looking at replacing our street lights with LEDs, but if you look at page 81 there under street lighting Durham, like we're paying Mr. Johns, Powerline Construction. We paid him street light repairs. We paid him $2,300. Then we paid $1,200. Then we paid $1,600. And we paid $1,800. And then if you look further down, there's a few other ones, and there's some above for Elmwood. It just seems like we're paying a lot of money for repairs. I'm just curious, what are those repairs that we're paying for? And is it because our street lights are getting old, or why are we paying so much money for repairs?
Okay, and Ken probably would be the best one to ask
mm-hmm.
that
mm-hmm.
to, I think, Councillor Hutchison. Carrie just doesn't have all that information here right now. But there's some, and yes, that maintenance cost, and they're spread out over the whole municipality, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
It sure seems like a lot of money.
Okay, noted. And yes, yeah. I do believe we have some measures that we're working on right now to see if we can't mitigate some of those costs, especially going forward. Is that going to suffice for now, Doug?
I guess we can, again, we can question Ken maybe at a later date, and maybe he'll give us an answer.
Okay.
I have another one on page 95, which basically has to do with our insurance costs. And we are Craig and Donald Redden, I guess, is our broker for now. And again, I understand our insurance costs are high. You know, when you see things like $96,000 for insurance premium in one shot, that's a lot of money. And then there's a lot of other bills in there too. So I guess that's the nature of the beast these days, that we're paying a lot of money for insurance. And we already, they're new, right? They're a new broker since we switched over.
Through you, Deputy Mayor, to the Councillor Hutchison, if I may jump in here. Yes, we put a tender out for insurance this year.
Yeah.
The tender, we changed insurance providers from Jardine Lloyd Thompson to Frank Cowan Company. Craig McDonald Redden is a local broker that's working with Frank Cowan Company. So yes, we switched. So they are a broker,
right,
but our actual provider of insurance is Frank Cowan Company.
Okay, so they work through Cowan.
Correct.
Okay. Right.
Go ahead, yeah, absolutely, Carrie, go ahead.
And when you see that, that's just one sort of department allocation. The actual insurance renewal was about $250,000, but that dropped.
Mm-hmm.
We were up over $400,000 for annual
mm-hmm.
premiums, but yeah, that's just, you'll see other several lines throughout the departments that we're allocating the premium, so that 96 is just the Public Works allocation of part of that premium.
Right, okay, and that, I guess I didn't understand with Craig McDonald Redden, we're working through
McGowan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Anything else on the vouchers? All right. I do have a motion here moved by Councillor Cutting, seconded by Councillor Lawrence. Be resolved, the Director of Finance Treasury be authorized to pay the accounts presented as voucher number 26-2015. Of the Municipality of West Grey in the amount of $169,468.17, and voucher 2/2016 of the Municipality of West Grey in the amount of $697,679.45. Any question on the motion? All in favor? Opposed, if any? And that would carry. Okay. Very good. All right. Second item we have revolves around the Children's Safety Village. Carrie, can you give us a little background on that, please?
Yes. So the Children's Safety Village, they had made a presentation to council previously. So they actually had their building permit issued for some of the renovations on the admin building at the former Conservation Authority. And so they're looking at requesting council consideration for a donation in lieu of those fees. So looking for council direction.
And just to be clear, they wanted us to waive those fees, but as we cannot do that according to our procedural bylaw, if we have to collect those fees, and then if we choose to issue that back to them. So what is the feeling of council? Councillor Hutchison.
Well, didn't we already make a decision that we were going to wait until things were up and running before we decided on what we were doing in terms of fundraising? I thought we had that discussion in one of our committee of the holes, maybe. I thought there was a decision made on how we were going to handle that anyways.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we're going to receive that. You're saying, Councillor Hutchison, I might. You're going to receive this, and we'll deal with this at a later date.
Well, yeah, I think we have dealt with it. It's just I think we've decided that we were on hold until at a later date, until we see where everything was going. Is my understanding.
Okay.
73.
Direction that's suitable for everyone, Councillor Marshall.
Yes, I would say that we just decline this request at this present date, and then If we wanted some discussion about donating money at another time, we can have that discussion, but we just declined this request so that it's not hung out there on the branch. It's off the table.
Okay, we're going to send them back a letter to say that we've received their request, and we'll consider it at a future date. Is that the direction the council is looking for here? I see some heads nodding, but I don't see too many. Go ahead, Councillor Marshall.
Well, I would say we send them a letter saying that we would decline this request, and if you want to put another paragraph in there, that we might entertain some other financial contribution at a later date. We might do that, but as far as this request go, we would decline because it's not in our policy to do this or whatever the wording would say.
Yeah, goes against her.
Councillor Lawrence.
Well, I think that's a little confusing because this isn't a policy here. We did not grant them the waiving of the fees. What they're asking for is a donation, and what they're asking for on the table is the amount that they paid. But they're, this isn't asking us to waive the fees, so to say it's not our policy isn't correct. I would rather that we send and say we did receive it. I've had discussion, and we'll be dealt with that later. Maybe dealt with at a later date. Did we anything at all in the budget hearing under grants?
It was deleted from the budget when you went through your grants organizations. Not at this point. You have your miscellaneous 1500 that hasn't been identified, but it was removed from the but grants organizations when we did the budget discussions.
Okay. So a letter will be sent back to Mr. Leach regarding this item. All right, I see everybody's in agreement with that.
Let's think of the letter to work.
Councillor Lawrence, you better turn on your mic or people out, please.
Let's leave it to Larry to word it properly to capture the feeling of council, but not to say it's not our policy because it's got nothing to do with policies here.
Very good. Okay. Okay, next. We had some other news regarding the community infrastructure program that seems like this recording keeps getting played over and over again. Carrie, go ahead.
Yeah, it's just for council's information. Another one, we had applied for the Durham Water Well project, but it was not approved. The recreation door openers, we had also applied under the enabling accessibility, and we did receive a grant under a different program. But so that's just sort of an update on another unsuccessful attempt.
It's the old try again thing. So we're trying, but it's not where we're striking out, but we're trying to do some business and good for the community. But we'll keep on trying. So, Councillor Marshall,
do we get a list, Carrie, of what grants did get approved across Canada? Is there?
It may be available online on the website. They don't send out the listing, but I may be able to get it on the quite often they have a list of successful applicants and projects. I can check.
Be interesting to see if they're approving a grant for a $3 million arena project somewhere, but they're not approving a grant for a water system. Maybe we can levy that towards what they're approving grants for if they are. I believe this one was for water and sewer and
the well project.
Yeah, and that the whole 150 wasn't not just for water, and it was for everything. So it would be interesting to see what they're are approving the grants for.
Okay. Yes, it always is interesting to see that how that formula works and what projects are being approved. All right. Anything else for us, Carrie?
Nope, that's all. Just a reminder, if you haven't submitted your timesheet, if you do that today. Is Ken have a report?
Ken's report.
Just go get it.
Sure. All right. Terry's gone to get Ken is next.
Mr. Deputy Mayor, could you move on to the clerks while we're waiting on Ken? There's something I wanted to bring up that I have to leave. I told you about
it. Oh, yes. Yeah, so, we can move ahead and do that, even if everybody's okay with deviating slightly from the agenda. Okay, the clerk's report. Ken is on his way here, Councillor Lawrence, you go ahead on that, please.
Well, it's a second. It's a second item. Do you want to be on first, or?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get caught up here. Okay. Second item regarding the Lions Club. That's what you wish to do. Okay. Councillor Lawrence does have an appointment before 11 o'clock, so she has asked that we look after this first. Please go ahead, Councillor Lawrence, regarding the Durham Lions Club.
Thank you. And I have no problem with the Lions, what they've asked for. In fact, I either moved or seconded the motion. But what I want to bring up, and we won't make the changes today, but the policy that came with it, the municipal alcohol policy of August the 3rd, 2011, and I would ask that that be reviewed and amended. In number E, it calls for Ayton, Lamlash, Dornock Hall facilities are not eligible for liquor licensed events. That shouldn't be Ayton, and I should have caught that when this came through. That should read Glen Elg. And certainly at the Centennial Hall in Ayton, there are many occasions where there's special permits. So that needs to be amended. And then in number D, it states that the arena and spectator seating area are not suitable for liquor licensed event. And so I ask, what about the warming area now in Durham? It's technically a spectator seating at this point. It is used as a blue line club by the Thundercats at times, and they shouldn't have to come each time for approval. So could the Durham warming room be listed as an exception in Clause D? So I would ask that staff look at that and hopefully bring another policy back to us with those changes. Certainly Ayton shouldn't be listed as not being eligible. It should be Glen Elg.
And it's under my, shall we say, yes, as far as the letter goes. Okay, this special event, yes, they want to use the whole arena, so I would naturally presume it's the warming room and the stands and...
But I'm speaking on going, you know, the...
Yeah, I think it is. Yeah, it is. Want to use the stands in the arena for this event on May the 14th.
Yeah. But that's
No.
I'm just speaking of the policy and asking that it be brought back with those
yes
changes. I'm certainly not against the Lions using the whole thing. It was used at Old Home Week and it went very well and gives a bigger area.
Right. So Ayton needs to be deleted and Glen Elg needs to be added. Yes. Okay.
And the warming room as an exception. Durham.
Okay. Very good then. Councillor Thompson, go ahead.
Yeah, on that, we did that for homecoming, like you said, on that for the, and I was asked by the Lions to the rec committee, and we're taking the glass panels out of the board. So, but they have to do that to get their liquor permit. So I was going to ask, and thank you for looking that up and seeing that Ayton was in there mistakenly, because we have to apply very shortly for the homecoming permits, because we are using Centennial Hall as a licensed area also. So if we could ask that be pushed ahead real quick, then we can get our license applied for.
Okay. So that direction's been given. Does that look after that order of business, Councillor Lawrence? Okay. Why don't we, we do have a motion here why don't we look after this right now, do this motion? Okay, moved by Councillor Cutting, seconded by Councillor Lawrence. Be resolved that the Council Municipality of West Grey hereby supports the request from the West Grey Durham Lions Club to use the entire Durham Arena / stands as well as the floor area in the special occasion permit for the community raising event, the Caverners Beatle Tribute Band on the 14th of May from 7 to midnight. And is it understood in there that the warming room will be used also, or should we add that? Just looking for clarification. The stands as well as the arena floor, I think maybe we should put in there.
Well, if it's in there and they want to use it, it would be covered. If they don't want to use it, that's fine too.
What's the feeling, Councillor Hutchison?
So they're not using the closed-in area upstairs above the stand then, right?
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. No, no, well, where they have the food booth. There. They're not using the mezzanine.
I wouldn't think so because they can't take the glass out of there, and this is going to be on the arena floor, the way I understand it. The whole arena floor stands, and so therefore, I guess the warming room would be the same. If they're not going to take the glass out of there, I'm pretty sure they'd be able to hear it in the warming room.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If I may.
Go ahead.
Mayor Eccles did ask me about this and to take it to the rec committee, which I did, and come back, and because it is in our liquor policy, and it's just an exception for the permit, so it probably wouldn't hurt to include the warming room. The glass and the glass below on the ice surface is not going to be removed. It's just going to be on the west bank of the ice surface that the glass will be taken out. But in the event, I would suggest it probably be beneficial to have that excluded for this period and have the warming room available for them. Not that they may use it, but it'll still be in there. And as far as Councillor Hutchison's, when we had homecoming, we excluded that snack bar area. That seating area was not was no alcohol allowed in there. Yeah. Okay. And there'll be signs posted for that purpose.
I have included it here right after the stands as well as the arena floor and warming area. Is that okay? All right, so motion's been duly moved and seconded. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. Yes. Yes, we'll go back here. Recommendation from the Committee of the Whole on the 25th of March. Committee of the Whole passed the following resolution during March 25th meeting. Council Orange, Council Marshall resolved that the Committee of the Whole hereby recommends Council authorize staff to negotiate a part-time employment contract for the fire prevention officer candidate. Okay? So that's, we did pass a resolution to support that from the Committee of the Whole. Further that, I have a motion moved by Carol Lawrence, seconded by Bev Cutting. Be it resolved that the Council of the Municipality of West Grey hereby authorize staff to negotiate a part-time employment contract for the fire prevention officer candidate. Okay? Everybody's aware of that? Saw that? Any questions? All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. Okay. Next, on the clerk's report, we received a letter submitted by Jean Tone requesting consideration to include Brady Becker to be authorized for the sports pictures. Is that something that needs to be dealt with here, or go ahead, Councillor Lawrence?
In the past, and as recently as our homecoming, it's Delisa Skeven that, and there's a committee that looks after that and gets the pictures and gets the information, and they made the, if you remember, Rob, they made presentations at the opening night of homecoming of those that were being added. I would hate to see this split up, and then, you know, you got to have one group looking after it, or there's certain criteria it has to meet, and I'm sure that probably meets it, and I mean, it's a good point to have them, but I think the committee that looks after it should do it, and it is Delisa Skeven, unless she, you know, abdicates, but up to this point, that's who's done it.
Is this something, go ahead, Councillor Thompson, but is this something that needs to go back to the rec board?
Yeah, as the council rep and chair of the rec, Durham Rec committee, this is new to, I didn't know this was going on, but there's really nothing, I mean, it'll go through, it's just a matter of, it should come to the rec committee for approval, and I do have the requirements from Delisa, and she hasn't been to the rec committee meeting for some time. It's been probably 3 years at least now. But it's something that can be dealt with, and I think we could deal with it at the rec committee, and I'll get in touch with Delisa and move forward on it. So, but I guess in the meantime, we'll just let Ms. Tone know that the rec committee will deal with it, and
Yeah, because to this point, it hasn't come to council, like it's been the rec committee and...
Yeah.
And to Lisa, as they say, and after Lisa left the rec committee, she did come for homecoming, Rob, to go through the people.
Yep.
So I'm sure if you invite her to come and...
Yeah.
So she won't know about this, so...
No, that's right. So I'll get in touch with her, and then we'll go from there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it shouldn't be an issue anyways.
No, so council, okay, so that's, Councillor Thompson's going to look after that through the rec board. Councillor Hutchison?
Just a question about that. So, this committee, they just look after the arena. There's Aiton, Newstead, would we have any committee or anything that looks after that area? There's nothing similar there?
Pretty much it's the facility manager and just working with the community. They don't have the same area or display that Durham has. So it's, yeah, it's something that, it still comes through the rec committee, so, yeah.
Okay. Direction's been, that's okay, Doug? Direction's been given to Mr. Thompson to move this ahead? Okay. Next item. Drinking water source protection plan and anything else that needs to be followed up on that? I see Mr. Gould's here. Welcome this morning, Ken, for that. But I think more than anything else, and I've read this a couple of times also, I think it just has to do with how deep we pile the snow in certain places. Is that right? Or go ahead, Ken, if you have something else to add. Yeah, just, that's under clerk's report, but I just wondered if you wanted to add anything on that.
Yeah, I guess there's new regulations, certainly regulations coming into effect here shortly, and I'm sure snow removal is going to be part of the regulations as to where it's piled for surface water getting into areas that they're not supposed to, so that'll be something.
Depending on whether that area is a collection system
That's
for
right.
various wells,
yeah,
so
yeah.
whether we have any of that so much that's going to be identified, I don't know that, but I think it's a minor detail.
Yeah.
But I do have a resolution moved by Doug Hutchison, seconded by Rob Thompson. Be it resolved that the Council Municipality of West Gray hereby endorses the proposed amendments to the Source Protection Plan in the Saugeen, Gray Sobel, North Bruce Peninsula Source Protection Region. Okay, and there's significant background information for that. Any other questions? Councillor Marshall.
So that would mean, Ken, that if we had a bad winter one time and we were anticipating Fresno ice building up at the upper dam, we wanted to move some snow up to build a berm along George Street, that we could not do that because of source water protection. We'd be moving snow into the source water protection area.
I'm not sure that, Don, whether that's a protected area or not, because there's no not close to the well there or anything on the north side of George Street, so.
Primarily on the east side of town, though, south of the river is in the source water protection area, even the north side of the river.
It could be an issue come up, yes?
Yeah. This is just one thing where it's just,
yeah.
This is one little step, one baby step in a process that 15 years from now, what are these regulations going to look like? How much are they going to branch out and cover? That will limit municipalities doing, or anybody, limit them from what they will do.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay, we have a resolution on the floor. Call the vote. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. I don't think if anybody has anything else to add on behalf of the clerk today. Nothing else? Very good. Okay, back to Ken's report. Thanks for coming in this morning, Ken. Make a comment on the Newstead drinking water inspection report.
We had the MOE CC, I guess now, do a inspection on the Newstead drinking water system on December the 9th of last year, and they found a couple of minor problems that we've since rectified. One being they weren't satisfied with the way the well cap was on. They had it locked on, and I guess there was a little bit of movement in the locks, and they asked it to be bolted down, so it's been done. We've ordered chemical spraying signs, no chemical spraying signs for the around the wells, for the as there is farming operations going on in that area. And then they were concerned about legible entries in the logbook, and that's kind of been rectified through a retirement, so I think we're good there too. Other than that, it's a pretty good report.
Okay. Any concerns, questions for Mr. Gould on any of that? Yes, I read through it and didn't see any big roadblocks ahead, so that's good news. All right, do we have a... That was just for information?
Yeah.
Okay. Very good. Nothing else to report then, Ken. Obviously, the winter's staying good and everybody's happy in the countryside. Go ahead, Doug. Thank you.
If I may ask a question to Ken, brought up earlier in Kerry's report about the streetlights.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And in the vouchers, there seem to be a lot of expenses for streetlight repairs. Can you, what's that all about, Ken? Can you tell us?
Yeah, the contractor was a long time getting, they had to chase them to get the invoicing in so they could, girls could do the year end. So he's brought a whole bunch in from 2015, I guess, probably about 6 months worth, I think. So it kind of looks like there's a whole lot there, but it's spread over probably a 6 month period. So, but there is certainly in Durham, the wiring's getting older and connections and stuff, and seems to cause problems.
So I guess with if we're looking at replacing, then maybe that's not a bad thing. If we're getting into a lot of repairs, we're looking at replacing with LED lights. Hopefully that'd solve some of our repairs, right?
Yes, and when they're replacing the lights, I'm sure they'll look at the connections and wiring and everything, and because I'm sure it's outdated as well. Okay.
Thanks for that update. Ken, anything else for Ken? Any member of council? Very good. Thank you, sir. All right. This time, I think we're down to CAO Deputy Clerk's report. Mr. Adams, welcome this morning.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Appreciate that. Your deputy mayorship worship, sir. Just some items here for information. The first item is we've got an invitation to an appreciation evening. Should members of council or staff wish to attend, please advise Laura and coordinate through our office. That's an invitation that was received. Second is to keep council up to date on the Director of Infrastructure and Public Works. The opportunity for submitting resumes closed on the 29th of January. The subcommittee did take a look at the applications. There were 7 applications received. We shortlisted the 4, and we will keep council informed as we move along in the interview process. I had to change this a couple of times. The 2016 Good Roads delegations, we've submitted for 6 delegations. I've heard back from 1 at this point in time. I certainly hope they get back to us in a timely fashion, so we're not scrambling to do reports over the weekend of the Good Roads Conference. But just to let council know, the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change has agreed to meet with us on February 22nd. I'm still waiting for them to confirm a time, but I will keep council appraised as we move forward with that. So again, that's for council's information. The Multi-Municipal Waste and Recycling Collection Group, that includes the municipality surrounding us, ourselves, Grey Highlands, and Chatsworth. The RFP is closing on February the 19th. As in the past, Mr. Gould, either Mayor Eccles or Deputy Mayor Bell and I will be participating in the joint venture on behalf of West Grey. Following the closing of the RFP, it goes through a very detailed review And from there, we will be making a recommendation back to council. But just to remind council, June 30th is when our current contract lapses. So we are going to be closing this and doing the detailed review and reporting back to council on that matter. And once again, that is for council's information. The last item on my report is a petition, Preserve Community Schools. This is received by Bill Raycroft, Chair of the Community Schools Alliance. It is a petition that's specifically defined for one community school, but you can modify that to a local school that's currently under consideration. But the problem is the time frame. They were hoping to have the information into the local MPP by February the 10th. It doesn't leave us a whole lot of time, but as you can see, I just received it a week ago, so I'm passing it along at the first opportunity. So that's also for council's information. If there's any questions, I'd be happy to entertain them. Mr. Deputy Mayor.
And we do have a resolution here to support this, but is there any questions for CEO Larry before this? There may be questions after I read this, so okay. We'll move along. Do have a resolution moved by Doug Hutchison, seconded by Rob Thompson. Whereas it is right for Ontario youth to be educated in their home communities, and whereas accessible schools that students can walk, bike, or take a short ride to promote healthy lifestyles, a cleaner environment, and emotional well-being, and whereas the economies of smaller rural towns are directly strengthened and vitalized by high schools in their own communities, and whereas community schools best serve special populations, and whereas rural high schools more than 15 kilometers from the next high school should be considered eligible for enhanced top-up funding. Now therefore, be it resolved that the Council of the Municipality of West Grey hereby petitions the Legislative Assembly of Ontario to direct and support and resources to Ontario rural community schools, such as Harrow District High School, so as to provide and sustain accessible education for youth within their home communities, preserving and sustaining rural small town culture that diversifies the fabric of the province of Ontario. Any questions on the motion? Pretty self-explanatory, and this comes from the Community School Alliance, okay, that we do pay a certain amount of money to every year, and we just approved that. I think it was $750, I think, last council meeting. All right. Okay, I'll call the vote. All in favor? Opposed, if any? That would carry. All right. Larry, anything else for us today that's not on your report?
I believe that brings you up to speed on the information that I have available to me, Mr. Chair.
All right, thank you for that. Okay, we're down to bylaws. And we have three bylaws, I think, here today, or four. Four bylaws, excuse me. First bylaw, moved by Rob Thompson and seconded by Doug Hutchison. Be it resolved that bylaw number 9/2016, being a bylaw to stop up and close part of a municipal road described as part of Rock Street, registered plan number 502, part 1, plan 16R10671, being part of property identification number 37227-0330LT in the former town of Durham, municipality of West Grey, be now read a first, second, and third time, passed and numbered, and that the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and CAO deputy clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation, engrossed in the bylaw book. All right, and this is some property that municipality is disposing on Durham Road, I believe. Okay, any questions on the motion? All in favor of this motion? Opposed, if any? That would carry. All right, second motion is a motion 10/2016, This has been moved by Doug Hutchison, seconded by Rob Thompson, be resolved that bylaw number 10/2016, being a bylaw to further amend bylaw number 86/2011, being a bylaw to provide a policy for the distribution and sale of West Gray garbage bag tags to Grant and Patricia Fisher/Riverside Campground and Store, be now read a first, second, and third time, passed and numbered, and that the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and the CAO deputy clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation, be engrossed in the bylaw book. All right. Is there somebody wanting to sell bag tags in the top end of Benning Township? Which is great for the convenience of the people in that part of the world. All right. Any questions on this bylaw? Call the question. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. Third bylaw, it has been moved by Rob Thompson, seconded by Doug Hutchison, be resolved that bylaw number 11/2016, being a bylaw to authorize the mayor and CAO/deputy clerk to enter into a site plan agreement between the Municipality of West Gray and Southeast Gray Nonprofit Homes, be now read a first, second, and third time, passed and numbered, and that the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and CAO deputy clerk, sealed with the seal of corporation, and be engrossed in the bylaw book. And this came through council, I think, 3 or 4 months ago, as pertaining to some property being added on to. Okay. Any questions about the resolution? Call the question. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. And the last one we have today, just the bylaw to confirm the proceedings of the meeting here today. Moved by Councillor Hutchison, seconded by Councillor Thompson. Be it resolved that bylaw number 12-2016, being bylaw to confirm the proceedings of the February 8th, 2016 council meeting, be now read a first, second, and third time, passed and numbered, and that the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and CAO deputy clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation, be engrossed in the bylaw book. Any questions on this? Call the question. All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All right. Thank you, Carrie. Mark, down to...
Mark does have a new business item, declaring the land surplus to the needs.
All right.
Okay. I don't know if it'll be on yet.
No, it won't be. So, under new business, the declaration of lands a surplus to the needs of the municipality, part of Rock Street, registered plan number 502, part 1, plan 16R10671, part of PIN 37227-0330LT. See the resolution. So that was under new business to give that. We've already dealt with that pertaining to the motion that we just passed. Okay? We still have to...
The bylaw to stop up the lot or the highway, and then this is declaring that parcel as surplus lands to the municipal needs. So
surplus municipal needs, and then of course that can
be
advertised to what council is aware of as to how we wish to do that business. Okay, so it has been moved by Doug Hutchison, seconded by Rob Thompson. I'll read the resolution. Be resolved that the Council of Municipality of West Gray hereby declares land as surplus to the needs of the municipality described as part of Rock Street, register plan number 502, part 1, plan 16R10671, being part of property identification number 37227-0330LT in the former town of Durham, Municipality of West Gray, to be sold through request for quotations with a minimum reserve bid of $60,000. Okay, everybody's aware of this. All right, I'll call the question. If there's no questions, all in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. All righty. Okay, and we had one item pulled from the our correspondence earlier regarding the Ontario Autism. I do have a move by Rob Thompson, seconded by Doug Hutchison. Resolved that the Council of Municipality of West Gray hereby proclaims April 2nd, 2016 as Autism Awareness Day and authorizes the raising of the Autism Ontario flag at the West Gray Municipal Office at noon on April 4th, 2016. Any question on the motion? All in favor? Opposed of any? That would carry. Okay, new business done. Any addendums? Councillor Marshall.
The library board is kind of in limbo what the agreement is going to be for moving into Elmwood. Is that agreement going to be brought to the table today, or is it ready to be brought to the table today? Or
I will ask Mr. Adams, CAO, for a little clarification on that point. Go ahead, Larry.
That document was sent out to both the church and to the library board requesting information and documentation back. To date, we have received nothing back from the church nor from the library board in regards to that, so I'd have nothing to bring to the table at this point in time.
So they're waiting for, the council is waiting for a letter from the boards?
Council is waiting for a signed document back from the church board, which has not been received at this point in time.
Okay.
It has been.
Once that comes back, then it will be brought to this table for formal adoption.
Very good.
Okay.
It has been, if I might add to that, it has been gone through our legal perusal.
By staff, it's been reviewed by our insurance carrier, and it's also been reviewed by legal. That's correct. And circulated to all parties involved.
Okay, Don. Good. Thank you. Okay, we look forward with eager anticipation to getting that mess looked after. Councillor Hutchison, go ahead.
Yeah, I thought I sort of was under understanding that that was going to happen today because I was talking to the librarian and she's ready to move in this week. Given that things were going to happen, they're supposed to be, the cabinet's supposed to be delivered. So I don't know whether we can speed that process up, but we're already mid-February and we hope to be in there at the beginning of February. So I don't know whether it's just a miscommunication on their part, but it sounded like they'd already, they've been talking back and forth between the church and the library, and they, and it sounds like everything was a go-ahead, but again, we haven't got that signed document, which can we make it that once we get the signatures that we can go ahead, because I know she wanted to open up next week and was hoping to be in there Thursday to get organized of this week. So
please, Larry, go ahead.
I believe my email to all parties was fairly straightforward, that when I delivered it to them, they were to review it and if there was any issues to get back, and I was anticipating it to be returned, signed, so that we could complete the documentation today. Until the documentation is completed and signed and returned to us for adoption by our part, we have no agreement with that. Verbal is one thing, but in today's society, we need to have it in writing.
All right. So.
Yes. Yes, we would like to move this along. I understand your frustration, Doug, as I am the same.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And we got to have it signed. We can't have any hiccups here dealing with that. So. Can I ask, Larry, when was the last time you had communication with the church?
Last week there was emails back and forth.
Okay.
But there was no documentation returned, so I will follow up again today.
Perfect. Thank you.
So just to clarify that then, so we're looking at probably coming back to council on the 18th with the document, which is, no, sorry, that's not right. I'm looking on wrong one there. 15th. Which is next Monday, and then going from there, I guess. So
hopefully we can make that timeline work.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thanks for that, Doug. All right, I don't believe we had any notice of motions or direct motions. No, yes, we did. Yeah, we've dealt with those all, yep. All right, closed session. I don't think we have any incomplete items from closed session. Only matters arise from closed session. We're done. We're down to question period, and we're a little bit early, but not sure if anybody was coming specifically for a question period today or not, but we do have a question from Diane. Please, Diane Jones, welcome this morning.
Just more of a comment and a compliment, and just representing the library board, we really appreciate the work and the advocacy that the Deputy Mayor John Bell and Councillor Doug Hutchinson have provided to the library board and our ongoing work with Don Marshall. So we just want to publicly thank you. You've been putting in time and just helping to strengthen our library system.
Well, thank you very much for that kind comment. And yes, going forward, we definitely want to keep working with the library board. There's a few other issues that we have to shall we say, address, and going forward, all in good time. So unfortunately, sometimes, as Mr. CAO said, the documentation part of it in today's society seems to take up a lot of time, and regarding insurance issues and all those kind of good things. So those things are progressing, and we do look forward to, shall we say, a successful completion of some of those items. So, okay, thanks for that, Diane. Any other questions from anyone? I don't see any, seeing none. Oh, Mr. Crosby, our media person. Welcome this morning, Don.
Can I see the miscellaneous correspondence?
Miscellaneous correspondence is down in this envelope.
Okay, I'll get it, I'm sure.
Okay. Fair enough. Seeing no other questions, Municipal Act notices. I don't believe we have any. I think we're down to that final one piece of council business today. Councillor Hutchison moves that we adjourn. We'll accept that motion, number 20. Very good. Thank you very much, council. You can go out and enjoy the rest of this nice, mild day.
Mm-hmm.